Ms. Stefanik.
Thank you, Ambassador Sondland, for your service. And I also want to thank you for your recognition in your opening statement of your hardworking staff at the U.S. mission to the EU. Mr. Sondland, you testified that you never received any direct confirmation or specific information as to why there was a hold on aid.
That's correct.
And in fact, you testified, quote, "President Trump never told me directly that the aid was conditioned on the investigations," end quote.
That's correct.
You said, quote, "Never heard those words from the president," correct?
Correct.
Instead, you testified that in your September 9th call with President Trump, the president said, quote, "No quid pro quo. I want nothing. I want nothing. I want President Zelensky to do the right thing, do what he ran on," end quote. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And the fact is, the aid was given to Ukraine without any announcement of new investigations.
That's correct.
And President Trump did, in fact, meet with President Zelensky in September at the United Nations, correct?
He did.
And there was no announcement of investigations before this meeting?
Correct.
And there was no announcement of investigations after this meeting?
That's right.
And you've been very clear when Chairman Schiff has asked you broadly about investigations. You've corrected that to say specifically your understanding of investigations are investigation into the 2016 elections and investigations into Burisma. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And are you aware that during the Obama administration, the U.S. partnered with the UK and Ukraine on an investigation into the owner of Burisma as part of Ukraine's anti-corruption efforts?
I became aware of it today during the hearing.
Other witnesses have testified, but yes. And in fact, the Obama administration's State Department was concerned about the potential appearance of conflict of interest with Hunter Biden serving on the board of Burisma because they raised this as they were preparing Ambassador Yovanovitch for her Senate confirmation. Are you aware of that?
I'm not aware of it.
She testified, when I asked her that question, both in the open hearing and the closed deposition. And I've asked most of our witnesses this, and every witness I've asked has said yes, and I want to ask you this today. Do you believe that Hunter Biden having a position on the board of Burisma has the potential appearance of a conflict of interest?
I don't want to characterize Hunter Biden's service on the board one way or another. I just don't know enough.
So you disagree with every other witness that has answered yes, there is a potential appearance of a conflict of interest.
Well, you asked if there was a conflict or an appearance
of a potential. My quote was the potential appearance of a conflict of interest.
Oh, I didn't hear the word appearance. Well, clearly it's an appearance of a conflict.
Correct. Clearly it is an appearance of conflict of interest. Again, this is something that every witness has answered yes to or agreed with it could have a potential appearance, and yet we are not allowed to call Hunter Biden to answer questions in front of this committee. Thank you again for your truthful testimony today, and I yield back.
Thank you.